Hi, welcome to another episode of Saving Money Inside the Home. Today we are going to make chicken stock. Now chicken stock is probably one of the easiest things you can do with a leftover rotisserie chicken. We had a leftover rotisserie chicken from Costco this week, which I made two or three meals out of, picked up all the chicken I could get off the bone, and now I just have the carcass left. Now I hate to throw it away because this is good stuff. You can buy chicken stock at the store, you can buy the chicken bouillon cubes, but they're full of preservatives, full of all kinds of stuff that you really don't want to put into your body, and you have to pay money for it. This I can make for practically free, so let me show you how easy it is. I'm going to make it in my crock pot, which makes it super simple because you don't have to tend to it and stir it or anything like that. You just put it all in the crock pot with just a few other simple ingredients. I just pulled a couple things out of my garden here that I want to use to flavor the stock. I've got some Swiss chard. I've got some carrot tops. You can pretty much use whatever you want. I have a couple of carrots I just pulled out of my refrigerator. They don't even have to be real great looking carrots. They can be kind of limp, not even, you know, super fresh or anything like that. I've got a couple of celery stalks with the leaves. I'm gonna use those. I've got an onion here that I chopped up, just rough chop it. I've got maybe three or four garlic cloves here and a couple of bay leaves. And all I'm gonna do is just dump it all into the crock pot. It's so easy. Dump in the chicken stock, chicken bones. Throw in the carrots. You can pretty much just use whatever you can find out in your garden to pick. You basically just want something in there to flavor the stock, flavor the water that we're gonna use to cover everything with. So you just throw it all in, throw in the bay leaves. Throw it all in. I'm gonna fill this up with water, and then I'm just gonna let this sit and simmer in my crock pot. We're gonna put it on low, fill it up with water, and let it sit for 24 hours. It'll kind of simmer along, it'll make your house smell really nice, and you're gonna have all the benefits, the health benefits of homemade chicken stock. So we'll come back in about 24 hours and show you what this looks like. It's gonna be fabulous. So chicken stock's been in the crock pot now for actually 48 hours. You can leave it 24 to 48 hours. I left mine in the crock pot for 48 hours. So let's take the lid off and see how it looks. Oh, it smells so good. Smells great, looks great. The next step is we're gonna ladle it into jars and get it ready to freeze. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and ladle it into this jar here. I've got my handy dandy funnel. Now you can see all of the vegetables and the chicken bones and everything are just totally cooked down. All the nutrients are cooked out of it and into the stock. So this stock is going to be super healthy to make soups and stews, to cook rice in. There's all kinds of uses for chicken stock. So let's go ahead and put it into this jar. You're going to want to do it kind of carefully so that all the extra vegetables and chicken bones and everything doesn't come through into your jar. You can also strain this through like a fine mesh strainer or in a regular strainer lined with coffee filters, but I'm just going to take a little bit out, put it in the jar just so we can see how it looks. And I may strain it down a little bit as it cools. Looks great. It's nice and dark. All those nutrients and flavor. And what's left here in the crock pot, you can pretty much just throw away. It's not really, we cooked all the nutrients out of it, so you don't have to feel badly like it's going to waste. But wow, look at this chicken stock. It's nice and dark. And also if you want to, you can, as it cools, you can put this in the refrigerator and then skim the fat off the top. So I probably will go ahead and strain this more because it does have a lot of the extra vegetables in it. But you can see it's a nice dark broth. It's gonna be great in my soups and my stews for this winter. So as soon as this cools, I'll go ahead and bag it up in quart freezer bags. I may even put some in ice cube trays so I have little bits for when I need a small amount. That's pretty much it. It's quick, simple, inexpensive. It's a great way to use some vegetables from your garden and those leftover chicken bones. So thanks a lot for watching and have a great, great day.